Like to introduce the CBC Browni tape recorder model TTR 402 high fidelity. Well, let's see what they mean by high fidelity. It appears that this model is running at significantly higher tape speed than the other models that I have shown you in my past videos. And this particular model comes with a little crystal mic, and you have three controls: record, play, stop, and rewind. And then it has a record and play switch, volume control, headphone, microphone. It's a beautiful little tape recorder, not very big, as you can see. And the Browni is I don't know what the CBC stands for. There is nothing in the little manual, if you want to call it a manual, printed in Japan. Comes with a schematic and basic instructions on how to operate the tape recorder, which is kind of a special thing to get a manual with this recorder. So I was tickled to be able to get that. So let's take a look inside. Just pops open, and there's a cover that's removable. The hinges are in pretty good shape. It has a little snap here to hold it in place. And you can see the unit. I love this 1950s coarse crinkle paint finish. You saw this on a lot of the old video projectors. 8mm, 16mm projectors would use that brown crinkle paint on their finishes as well. So this is the standard 3-inch reels, 2.5, 3-inch reels. And this particular player has the lockdown nuts that hold the tape reels in place, so you can shake it upside down and they don't fall out. The leather strap is in beautiful condition and very soft, and still in great shape. The battery compartment is located right here, and I'll open that up for you and we'll take a look at the batteries. And now I'll have to track down the screw that I just dropped on the floor, but you see it's got two C-size batteries for the motor control, and they're in parallel, so it's a 1.5 volt motor. And then it's got the transistor radio battery for the audio portion, much like the other tape decks that we have seen, that you have seen in my videos up to this point. Put the battery compartment back together. And let's see, I want you to see how fast the tape spins. And by the way, this is a reel drive rather than capstan drive. So it's not going to be as precise, and there's going to be a lot more wow and flutter. So you see the drive mechanism up there, the shiny little pin that goes up underneath the reel here. And there's another pin on this side. Don't know if you can see it. This is a larger pin so that it's a little bit slower rewind than fast than play. I just recorded a audio of the chimes, and you may have seen that video already. I just did a video on the Schulmeric chimes. So I played a track, and I'm not going to play the entire song here, but I wanted you to hear the quality of the music, and notice how fast the tape is running. So that's music, and music is always a pretty hard test for these old recorders, especially if you were trying to hope to get a decent reproduction of the music. Well, we're going to go ahead and do some voice recording now on the using the little crystal mic. And you could hear the noise on my crystal mic that I was holding during that song. So let's flip this into record. And we'll push play record. And the motor is making a lot of noise. But that's pretty much consistent with these type of tape recorders. So I'm talking about 5 to 6 inches away from the microphone right now, which is probably pretty hot. And we'll just do a little rewind here and listen to the High Fidelity Model 402. Okay, we're going to rewind.
Tape recorders. So
let's rewind. Without the recording on, I probably messed up my recording, but let's see.
Noise.
Let me go a little more.
And the motor is making a lot of noise. That's pretty much the tape recorders. So I'm talking about 5 to 6 inches away from the microphone right now, which is probably pretty hot. And we'll just do a little rewind here and listen to the High Fidelity Model 402.
Well, there you have it. It is a sweet little unit, and you can see the quality of some of the details that they put into this. I originally bought this and there was glue all over this. It was a mess, a real mess. They used some kind of an epoxy glue apparently and smeared it all over the plastic. So I popped this Browni label off and then sanded that all off, and it looks a lot better. I love that red and gold finish. But also the High Fidelity label there, you can see it's just really pretty. High Fidelity Model 402. Isn't that great? So this even has a little red mark right here. You notice you can push this in and it releases the tape. Let's see if you can see it. There we go. It releases the foam or the felt against the tape, so that you can replace the spools. So I'm going to do a little test now to determine the speed of these reels, because I can't find anything anywhere that indicates what speed these tapes are running, that this unit is running at. But I really would like to know, by comparison to the 1 3/4 and 3 7/8, or 1 7/8 and 3 3/4, whatever it is. So I'm going to do a little test, and then we'll come back and compare the 1 inch per second as opposed to this machine, so that you can see the two side by side. All right, I brought a couple of additional tape recorders here to compare. You probably have seen the Mission Impossible Craig tape recorder video that I did, the Craig 212. This is the Mission Impossible tape recorder. And so we'll run that at 3 3/4 speed. That's this little spindle, you remember. You can replace this capstan spindle, remove it for 1 7/8, and then if you install it, it runs the tape speed at 3 3/4. The same is true with the General Electric. And so I've got the General Electric set right now for 1 7/8. And this is the unknown CBC Browni. And we're just not sure about the speed of this tape recorder yet. So, and then I brought my Nagra in, and we will take the tape off of the high fidelity, and we'll put it onto the Nagra, and we'll see. The Nagra is currently set to run this tape at 7.5 inches per second. So I think that's the next step. So 3 3/4, which is 3.81 inches per second, 7.5 inches per second. So let's just see. And then, of course, this will run up to 15 inches per second, which is blindingly fast. I don't think it's going to be running that fast. So just for reference, here's what the high fidelity Browni is running at right now. Okay, so you get a feel for the speed there. And then let's come up to this one, and we'll get a feel for 1 7/8. Okay, so there's 1 7/8, and there's whatever. And then we'll run the Mission Impossible Craig 212, and that is 3 3/4. So there's 3 3/4, 1 7/8, and whatever that is. So you can see the difference in the speed. All right. So let's, I had recorded a segment here. We just heard it.
And the motor is making a lot of noise, but that's pretty much a tape recorder.
All right. So let's rewind that, and let's take it off of this machine and put it over here on the Nagra, and let's just see how it works with Nagra. Let me turn the Nagra on, see what's playing here. Okay, so we've got a really nice piece of music there that will cause all kinds of flags. So what we're going to do is I'm going to stop the tape. We're going to pop these reels off of this machine. And we'll put the high fidelity tape on to replace that one. So we'll take these reel tapes off, and I can't do this with one hand, so I'm going to stop the tape, and we'll take this tape off and put it over on that tape deck.
Talking about 5 to 6 inches away from the microphone right now, which is probably
pretty hot. And we'll just do a little rewind here and listen to the High Fidelity Model 402.
Okay, this tape recorder is a mono, and
it's listening to the other track running backwards on this tape. But clearly, it's off speed just a little. That's not the fault of this super precision tape deck. This thing is probably as high grade as you're going to get. A Switzerland made instrument designed tape recorder. So I trust the speed is going to be, when it says it's 7.5, it's 7.5. So clearly, that's the speed that this little tape recorder is running. Very close to 7.5 inch per second. So that solves that mystery. And you can hear. Let's rewind and see what the music sounds like. And we'll have some talking because we're going to have two tracks playing at the same time.
The motor is making a lot of noise, but that's pretty much the tape recorders.
Okay, well, there we have it. I